U.S. National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan recently told Bloomberg Television during an interview that a Chinese invasion of Taiwan remains a distinct threat and the U.S. remains opposed to any effort to change the status quo by force. Meanwhile, a U.S. congressional delegation arrived in Taiwan on September 7th and met with President Tsai Ing-wen a day later.
On September 8th, President Tsai Ing-wen received a bipartisan U.S. congressional delegation. The visitors were Representative Stephanie Murphy and Kai Kahele from the Democratic Party, and Representative Scott Franklin, Joe Wilson, Andy Barr, Daryl Issa, Claudia Tenney, and Kat Kamick from the Republican Party. In her speech, Tsai thanked the eight visitors for their past support of Taiwan and for visiting Taiwan in a show of support following Chinese military exercises, saying this shows the great bilateral relationship. Tsai said Taiwan will not succumb to threats and will work with democratic partners to jointly uphold regional peace and stability. She also expressed her hope that the bilateral trade relationship can deepen.
One of the most important things Congress can do right now is to deepen economic relationship with Taiwan, and in particular, by pushing for a high-quality free trade agreement between the U.S. and Taiwan. And I personally would like to see a Ding Tai Fung in Orlando.
Murphy also spoke about deepening bilateral relationships and joked that she hopes Ding Tai Fung can open a restaurant in the Orlando area. Meanwhile, U.S. National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan told Bloomberg Television that a Chinese invasion of Taiwan remains a distinct threat.
It remains a distinct threat that there could be a military contingency around Taiwan, and the People's Republic of China has actually stated as official policy that it is not taking the invasion of Taiwan off the table. The American position has remained steadfast and consistent, and we will continue to push back against any effort to change the status quo by force.
Sullivan also spoke about the Taiwan Policy Act of 2022 introduced by members of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. He said it can effectively strengthen Taiwan's security, although he has concerns about part of the content. There are reports that the White House is worried that this bill will conflict with the U.S.'s fuzzy strategy towards Taiwan. Meanwhile, a delegation of five French senators visited the legislative yuan. There are reports that one of them tested positive for COVID-19 after arriving in Taiwan. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs said that it launched contingency measures in accordance with Central Epidemic Command Center regulations, and the senator will participate in events virtually. The ministry also said the senator was not in close contact with other members of the delegation, so they will be allowed to follow their itinerary.